Yeah, true. All right, everyone, we're going to start in a minute. I want to introduce Mateo. He's working for a company called Nethesis.
Yeah.
Am I saying it okay? I always feel bad about pronouncing things bad or poorly. He has told me he is hacking on a bunch of things, including a bit of Golang, but also he's getting married and his life will be much busier, so his coding skills might go downhill a little bit. So I want you to encourage him with a large round of applause. Please give it up to Mateo.
Thank you. Thank you, everybody. I want to say hello to my future wife, Akemi. Okay. Oh, okay. Can you listen? Can you hear me now?
Hi.
Okay, better. So, hi, everybody. In this talk, I'm going to show you how you can manage your DNS infrastructure as code and why this problem came to me. So, the problem was started almost a year ago when we used a web-based interface for manage our DNS configuration, and we have some problem like who have created the records, why this record was created, what does these records do? And most important, are still using, someone still using it? So, I was assigned to the task to solve this problem, to migrate from a web-based console to something more modern that can be on-premise or on the cloud. I have only two constraints. The one is that the solution must be versionable and or programmable, but most important, I have only one day, so I have to start in the morning and production in the afternoon. After some thinking, I think that the maybe on-premise solution full managed is too complicated, is will be hard to maintain, and too high learning step. Remember that I have only one day. If we use a provider for our infrastructure, there are so many, like, I don't know, DNS Simple, Amazon, DigitalOcean, and I was afraid that I can make the wrong choice and suffer from vendor lock-in. So I came out with a solution to use OctoDNS. OctoDNS is because is a file-based configuration, so I can easily version it with Git. It supports multiple providers, so I don't have to choose one, and is a provider agnostic, so I can use the same syntax configuration for every provider. In not like, for example, Terraform, where you have to use a different syntax for every resource, for every provider. OctoDNS was made by GitHub and usually internally for manage the infrastructure until it was released as open source project. And the configuration file are in YAML. Let's see a simple setup of OctoDNS. Here we can see in the providers block the definition of our provider. In this case, we have the config provider, that is the type of YAML providers, that is the directory where we are going to store the configuration of our records. And OctoDNS will be read from there. Then we have the DO provider, that is the type of DigitalOcean provider, and the token property will tell to OctoDNS to read the token for the authentication from the environment variable DO token. Then we have the zone configuration, where if we have our example zone. In the source field, we can find where OctoDNS will read the configuration, and in the target zone that you can see, we'll find the we'll find the provider where LocalDNS will apply the actual configuration. So we are going to read from the source and applying the target. This is the simple example of a configuration. We have we define an Apex domain with the record MX, the record A, and a simple www subdomain. How we can use OctoDNS? We can simply install with pip. We can verify the configuration with OctoDNS validate. With OctoDNS sync, we can test the configuration, and we can apply the configuration with OctoDNS sync with the option do it. The resulting directory layout of our project, of our zones, will be the configuration for OctoDNS and a directory with the zone configuration. As I told you before, we are going to version all the changes, so we are going to use Git. Why Git? Because she allows us to have an history of all the DNS change. We can relatively easily roll back in case of error, so with Git reset or Git revert. We can add a who and why to the DNS changes, and we can facilitate the process of the review of the proposed DNS changes. We are going to automatize all the things with Travis A, but what is the benefit of automation? One of the first benefits is that now we can apply a continuous integration to DNS change, because for every proposed change we are going to test it with Travis A. We can also apply a continuous deployment, because we are going to actually apply the change when we are going to merge to the master. And we can try to avoid a credential leak, because will be not the user to apply the actual change, but Travis C. So we are going to store the credential in Travis C. This is the simple configuration of Travis C. We can see that in the install part, we are going to install OctoDNS. Then, for every pull request, we are going to first validate the configuration. It's only a syntax validation. Then we are going to test the configuration to the actual production environment. And when we are going to merge the pull request to the master, we are going to apply the actual configuration with OctoDNS sync with the option do it. As told you before, OctoDNS, we are going to read the provider's credential from the environment variables. And in the case of Travis E, we are going to set this variable as secure, so the pull request from another repository can't read the variables. The resulting workflow will be that a user make a pull request with the request change. Travis C will test the change. A user ask a review of the pull request. Administrator can start the review. And if he want, can approve the change. Most important here, that will be the user to actually merge the pull request, so he can decide when is the case to do it, not early, not later. At the end, Travis E will apply all the change. Be warning that for OctoDNS, the only source of truth is the configuration. So if you are going to modify the configuration outside Travis E, Travis E will delete the records, because he can know if the record is present in the production environment, because we have deleted from the configuration of added outside the OctoDNS. Some advanced usage of OctoDNS can be the backup provider, so we can easily add a backup provider. Like in this case, I've added the configuration for the Cloudflare provider. As we can see in the last, in the CF block with the credentials stored in the environment variables. At the end, sorry you can see it, but we have our source provider like before, and we have the DigitalOcean and under the Cloudflare provider. So when we are going to apply the modification, OctoDNS will read the configuration from the config provider and apply to the DigitalOcean provider and to the Cloudflare provider. This type of configuration is used by my company in production for have a backup provider in case of failure. Another use of OctoDNS is for migrate between two providers. We have the same configuration of the provider as before, but in this case, as source, we have DigitalOcean, so OctoDNS will read the configuration from DigitalOcean and apply to Cloudflare. So is you can see, but behind is the Cloudflare provider. So all the records will be copied from DigitalOcean to Cloudflare. Other useful commands are the OctoDNS dump. In this case, OctoDNS will dump all the configuration from one supported provider to the YAML file. It can be useful for the migration. And OctoDNS compare. So OctoDNS will compare the configuration from the YAML file to the actual production provider. You can use this for see if there is some configuration drift. So, some quick recommendation if you want to use this solution. One of the first is the Quirks. As told you before, we are going to make secure the variable of the DNS providers. TravisCE will not allow the pull request from another repository to access to this variable. In this case, we have to modify the scripts for the validation of the pull request with the check that if the TravisCE secure envars are false, then we are going to set the variable with the credential to blank. Because with OctoDNS validate, we are going also, OctoDNS, when do the validation, the syncas validation, want also to access to the variables. And if we don't declare, we will see OctoDNS that complain because we are going to access to an existing variables. The other line is that if we are going to test a pull request from another repository, because we can't access to the secure variable, we can't also test the proposed change to the providers. Some recommendation is to protect the master branch, so permit the write only via pull request. Make mandatory for a pull request to be up to date before merge, so we are going to see what is actually applied, and maybe block the merge until almost one review approved the change. Okay, it was very quick. So at the end of the day, for me, it was mission accomplished. We move from a base point and click paradigm to an infrastructure as code paradigm. The DNS are now versionable, and we start in the morning and in production in the afternoon. That day, but the day after, when we have make sure that all the record was migrated correctly. So for us was a success, and what happened a year later, we still use it, so we find useful. We have 59 commits, 34 pull requests, 3 contributors. We start from with one zone, and now we have 4 zone managed with OctoDNS. And at the moment, we have only 88 records. Where before, I don't know if it's more than 88, because everyone can create and forgot about it. So it's, the low number of records is a success. And that's all. I'm maybe too quickly, but I'm Matteo Valentini, a developer in Italian open source company called Netlis. This is my contacts in case you want to reach me later, and if there is any question, I'm happy to answer.